But I've been really trying to be like a better person, you know, over this pandemic. I've lost 80 pounds over the last 2 years, right? Thank you. People ask me all the time. They're like, yo, what's the secret, bro? And I'm like, there's no secret. You just got to work hard, not eat everything you want to eat, and have patience. It takes time. And people are like, oh, sick. Nice. Thanks for the advice. But what's the secret, bro? You know? Like, I'm holding out on them. And I am. There is a secret. It's a very expensive secret. No, the weed's going to get you fat. What you got to do is you got to spend all your money on cocaine. All right? Yeah. You do fat lines, all right? You suppress your appetite. And then when you get the coke munchies, you know the coke munchies when you eat one chip really fast? You know? Replace that chip with mushrooms, all right? Yeah, now the potion is complete, all right? You're gonna be all sorts of fucked up, all right? And then you're gonna ask yourself, why am I this way? And then you'll sober up and you'll do one of two things. You will either lose the weight or you will kill yourself, all right? But either way, there will be less of you, okay? And this is not a pyramid scheme, all right? This is legit. I don't profit off this. But side note, I do sell cocaine and I do sell mushrooms. Let's get you on a meal plan, all right? We'll figure it out. We'll do this together. We'll be good. But for real, I'm trying to be a better person in all aspects of my life. Like, I know I throw everything down the condo garbage hole, but I want the environment to be sick, you know? Like, I want the environment to look like it wears a bandana, you know? You're like, goddamn, environment. You're sick, you know? But no, I'm trying. Like, but I also do piece of shit things at the same time. Like, I'll hotbox my car for 45 minutes with the AC on, right? Right? But then you look up and there's a sign that says no idling. And I just look at that sign and I go, I am no idol, I am a mere man. You know? And I just keep smoking. Just, just piece of shit. Just piece of shit behavior. But I'm trying to be better. I'm trying to be better. I stopped watching porn. I haven't watched porn in 2 years. All right? Yeah, I know. Thank you. I'm a god. It was tough. The only reason I stopped because I was once watching porn and I saw this meme, and it said only weak men watch porn. And I slammed the computer down, forgetting how hard I was, and just crushed my penis, and for the last 2 years, I've been unable to get hard. That's why I stopped the porn. But for real, I don't know how women watch porn, you know? You guys, I don't know how you do it, but this is how men watch porn, all right? We're at home with somebody, okay? And then that person leaves, all right? And now you are alone. And something about being alone makes you super horny, all right? And the more alone you are, the hornier you are, all right? And now this person leaves and you start doing math in your head, right? You're like, yo, how long is this person gone for? Because then the longer they're gone, the bigger the device, you know what I mean? Because if they're gone for 10 minutes, you're just like, yo, it's a quick thing on my phone, you know? But if they're gone for the day, you're like, I'm putting this HDMI cable into my computer, all right? And it's gonna be surround sound fucking, all right? Because I got all day, baby, right? But now I don't watch porn, so I don't choose horny time, you know? Horny time chooses me, all right? It's like I'm a wizard and the horny is the wand, all right? It picks you, all right? And it'll happen in the strangest places. Grocery store, you know? You're just walking around and you see 100 cantaloupes stacked on top of each other. And your dick just twitches, you know? Because they all look like a bunch of giant veiny tits all stacked on top of each other. And all you can think is stupid sexy fruit, you know? And like, you gotta have some respect for yourself when you jerk off, you know? You can't just jerk off laying on your bed into your belly button. It's wrong. Have some respect for yourself, all right? I want you to imagine every time that Miss Frizzle is teaching a class in your balls, all right? The magic school bus is in your balls, all right? And she's trying to teach the class how babies are made, all right? But that's the day you decide to jerk off into your belly button. And then they just land and they're like, this is not what was supposed to happen, you know? Giant towel comes, squish, whole class is dead, all right? If you're gonna jerk off, do it into a toilet and press flush, all right? Because at least give your sperm a chance, you know? Because then they think they're doing what God intended them to do, you know? They're just flying through the pipes trying to fucking find the end goal. But they hit shit at the end, right? Which is not too different from real life. For my anal lovers. Some people love it. They come in the bum. And what's waiting for the cum? Little bit of poo, all right? It's called cum poo. It's very real. It's like a chocolate ice cream cone dipped into vanilla, you know? It's item number 314 at most Asian restaurants. It's very real and it's very dangerous, all right? Like if I could throw something at you right now and you had to catch one of them, all right? COVID or kung poo, which one would you catch right now? You take kung poo? You take kung poo over COVID? This guy likes kung poo. I can't get over that. No one has ever said kung poo. There's no vaccine for that, bro. I'll take COVID every time, bro. What am I just gonna be hard for 5 days? No problem. I'll do it.